to do it.
That's true.
Yeah.
Okay, hello everyone. This is Ronnie from the Fruit Festival from YouTube, and today we've got another special guest and a little interview with someone that will be part of the festival this year, who's been in previous years as an attendee and is going to be maybe presenting, doing some workshops, things like that. And this is Harriet Kjaer, for those of you who don't know.
Yay.
So, Harry, would you want to introduce yourself a little bit?
Yeah.
Well,
my name is Harriet, and I've been a raw vegan 80-10-10 since almost 7 years now. And,
sure.
Well, I will be there, of course, to be with all these wonderful people, but but also to try to inspire people to do some more running or even walking, you know, which is, it's what happens mostly when you get a lot of energy. You also need to spend it. So it's good to have some tips on how to spend all this extra energy we get from the fruits and vegetables. So, Well, I'm from Denmark originally, but I haven't been living in Denmark since I was 17. And I've been living all over Europe, in France, in Germany, in England. Wonderful Spain with all this, its fruits.
So you live in Spain at the moment?
Yeah, I live in Barcelona.
I mean, you have quite an interesting job. What is it you do?
Yeah, people tend to think that it's more interesting than I actually do. But it's a job, you know. Yeah, I make and I repair violins and cellos and double basses. And it's interesting, of course. But it's a very nice way of earning your money. But I tend to get more, like, now I'm studying to become a nutritionist, something like this. And I tend to find that more interesting now than my actually job that I've been doing for the last... But I started actually to do my first violin when I was 14 years old.
Mm-hmm.
And now I'm 42, so you see, it's been quite a while that I do this, these things. And it's nice to start some new things, you know. And so it's a good, interesting way.
Yeah, fantastic.
It's new. And of course, I run, you know. That's why we're here.
Yeah.
I run, and I find that running with a lot of people, I get to run, and often they're very skeptical in the beginning. They say, but how can you do this with only the fruit? And when you run past them on the way up a hill, and they say afterwards, they say, what is this thing you do? Then they start to ask, and you know, you also go for runs with the people, and they start to get interested and see, yeah, something works, you know, because it does, and people want what you have.
Brilliant.
And so I've always been telling them what I know, but I wanted to know really what is going on inside the body. So I'm studying with Dr. Graham now, and we're just going through all the basics of the body, you know, how everything works, and just to understand it really, to know when you think about sodium or something like this, you know what's going on, all the chemical reactions, and what's going on, how, where it passes through, and just to have the knowledge of this, mainly to be able to explain it to people.
Brilliant.
Not in that complicated way that I just did, but it's been a long day, you know.
Yeah. Well, you obviously, I mean, I met you on a couple of festivals that I might have met you at the Danish festival a number of years ago. I think you've also did you go to the Woodstock festival as well?
No, I haven't. I was signed up for it, but then I swapped the ticket with you. So
that's
I could come to the UK instead because I had some family things.
Were you at the Slovenian festival?
No.
Okay.
But in relation to the Woodstock festival, it was really interesting actually, because became a raw vegan because I saw a video of Michael Arnstein on YouTube.
Oh, right, really?
He just said, I've been running up mountains and I feel like they're flat or whatever. And I was like, wow, this is really interesting. I want to try it. And just like the next day, I started to eat a pineapple. And then I've just been a raw vegan since, you know, it just like works. And I felt immediately when I started to have so much more energy and well, it wasn't very good, but I started to stop sleeping because I was just like too, I wasn't used to so much energy, you know. It was really amazing. And my marathon time went really down like by 40 minutes or something like this in a couple of months.
Oh, wow.
My 100 kilometer time went down 1 hour 20 or something. Really crazy improvement. I was like, wow, this is really, this really works. And it just does. So, you know, I started out with running a marathon and running a few marathons. And then I think I started to think, this could be really, I can do this thing. You know, I can do this without so much, it's not very difficult. It's difficult for me to run really fast, but I can run really fast. So I started to look for things that suits me better, like running really far. And now I do ultra runs and... Actually, just before the UK Fruit Festival, I will do, hopefully, I hope I will manage to do it, a race in Andorra, which is a mountain race of 233 kilometers.
Oh my goodness.
Self-sufficiency, which means that you have to run also with quite some luggage, you know.
Goodness
especially
sake.
As a raw vegan, it's a little bit complicated because you have to bring a lot of dried food, you know, because I can't bring like... 70 kilos of bananas. It's just, you know, you can't, I have to compromise on this one, but thankfully we also run through villages so you can get some fresh fruits at that day. It's a sort of, it's a way of, I wouldn't eat cooked food though, but I would eat dried fruit. So
sure.
That's as far as I would go.
Yeah, so for people that maybe haven't met you before, you're you do ultra runs, but the really long runs that you do. It seems like these are the longest runs.
Yeah, the last one I did was like I did it in 84 hours.
84 hours?
84 hours, yeah. I ran around Gran Canaria Island, but over the mountains. But of course, when I say run, it's a run, but we also walk a lot because it's a mountain run, you know. So it's mainly you walk when you, but you walk, I mean, I walk as fast as people run, mainly. You walk up the mountain and then you run down and when it's flat, but... yeah, and this is amazing. I mean, that's why I also wanted to talk about this in the talk, you know, about the exploring the limits of the human. Are there really limits, or did I just not meet it yet? And how to, when you meet your limit, how to sort of say, is this really the one, or can I enjoy going further? You know, because it's, of course it's all about enjoying it. How far do you enjoy to go?
So do you feel like you can go further then?
Yes. I mean, I mean, this race I did that was 83 hours. I didn't sleep at all and I felt fine, you know. I finished Saturday evening. I slept Saturday night and Sunday I went home with the plane and Monday I went to work on my bicycle. You know, it's it was 265 kilometers.
So you walked and ran 265 kilometers over 84 hours, and the next day you flew home and you were cycling to work.
Yeah. And of course, I feel when I see people that I run with, they go wobbling through the airport, and I feel like I think that we do something right with this diet, you know, because I feel my recovery is just immensely much faster, and I don't feel at all less. Because my body has all the nutrients it needs to recover really fast, and it's just like it just has to pick, you know. I need a bit of this, I need a bit of that, and it just has everything. I'm not saying that it's healthy to do what I do. Of course it's not, but it's really, really fun, you know, and it's just so much fun when you can do it. And it's just that I've been running for 150 kilometers now or 200 kilometers and I feel fine. I'm having fun and I can't even feel my legs. I don't feel, you know, it's just like, so I think, and this thing, I think you can find it also for shorter run, because of course many people will do shorter run, but it's about finding the right spirit, you know, to find the, because if you go around saying, oh no, I can't, it's too hard and all this, then of course you can't. But if you think that maybe I can and maybe I will just go and try to have fun, then I think you can go really a long, long time. And I think for people also beginning to run, so if you can't run, you just walk. It's okay, you know. It's and just to have fun with it. It's like tonight I went running with a friend that is also starting to become a raw vegan. I'm very proud of it. And he wants to do a marathon. So, you know, when you start to inspire people, it's really great. And he was, and we went through this forest, and it was really like, I think it was a BMX track or something like this. And we just went running like crazy. And I just said, the world is a playground, you know? We just go to play. We don't go to train hard, and it has to be hard, and you know, it's just playing. It's just playing around and searching for, I can do this, I can do this. And I think it's great fun. I mean, for me, that's when I don't have fun anymore, I would just stop, you know? And when I did this long race, there were some people, they were just complaining all the time. They were just like, why did they make us go through this? And it's too hard, there's no protection, it's really dangerous. I mean, we were climbing rocks during the race. People had to stop and turn around because they didn't know how to get up there during the race. And there were people, some people called the organization to complain. And I was like, but hey, it's your choice to be here. You can just stop. Come, stop if you're not happy, you know. They did the race. They can choose how they want it to be. And I think it's all about this. It's our choices, all of it, you know.
Yeah.
And many people, I think everybody know. I'm here. They know that what they eat, it's not doing them any good, you know. People know this. They choose to ignore it for the most part of time, and that's their choice. But yeah, I think people choose, and they know. It's and I choose to have fun with whatever you can do with the body, and yeah.
Brilliant.
And I would really like to do it with a lot of people from the, and with Grant, of course, and with Ted. I think Ted is coming also, no?
Yeah.
So it's really three different running profiles. I mean, Ted is really fast, really technical. I'm really just running far like Grant. Actually, the difference between Grant and me is that he runs very little, he trains very little, and I train a lot.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because I think he said, yeah, I think I ran maybe 30 or 40 kilometers this week for training for a 200 kilometer race. And he's like that, you know, and I just train a lot. I mean, I do 100 kilometer training weeks, 120, 130, sure. Because I really, really enjoy. And it's part of, for me, the races are not, it's not the point. The point is to wake up in the morning, I go to see the sunrise. I mean, you probably can see it on most of my photos on Instagram. I mean, they're almost all from sunrises because I really just, you know, you go and you run, you do your training. That is, sometimes it's 1 or 2 hours. And then I go home and I eat my banana smoothie and then I go to work. And it's like, instead of coffee in a way, you know, it's like, I can't wake up really if I don't go running. It's like, yeah.
So that's, you wake up running, basically?
Yeah. Wow. Sometimes I'm wearing the shoes and I didn't even realize how I got out of the door, you know. I'm still sleeping. And I just go out and then I start, now it's coming. And I think this is really the enjoyable part. The race is just a detail. It's a good excuse or like a goal or something like this. But the main part is just about enjoying every day.
Yeah.
Enjoying this routine that I think we are routine people. We do things. And I really feel that the more I do everything the same way every day, the more I can really settle into the routine and enjoy it, because I also, the body knows what is going on, you know, it knows. Of course, if I stop running completely for a week or two, it's also okay. It's like, I need to rest. I don't feel like going running and then I don't go. So. But it's about finding these small things that makes that a life is really, really, really beautiful and adventurous also. Sometimes to go on your own to the mountain and just go for 2 days and think, oh, if I fall, I can die. But, you know, if it's my turn, it's my turn. You can also die if on the sofa. I mean, you probably have more probability of dying on the sofa than if you go to the mountain. So I'm not afraid of this. It's life. Shouldn't be afraid of living.
Fantastic. That's a great. You've got a fantastic attitude.
But
how do you develop that? Is that just natural?
I don't know how you develop it. You have to believe, you know, that maybe I can. I think it starts with this. Maybe I can do it, you know.
Sure.
Maybe I can do it and just think, you know, it's like if you go for a training run with some friends and they're really fast and you go like, oh, a little bit scared. I don't know if I, probably I can't run like as fast as them, and then you can't. But then sometimes you say, okay, today I have a headache, or doesn't actually happen, but I have pain in my knee. No, I don't have pain anywhere. But anyway, you say, okay, I'm not so good shape today. No, I didn't sleep very well. This is one of the things that really can affect me. And so I say, but I'm just going to, you know, stroll along. I'm not going to go very fast. And actually those days are the ones that you run the best, because you take off the pressure. You don't put yourself on that. I have to perform, and I have to, I always say, if I go to a race, I say, well, I hope I can do it. I hope I can manage. But if not, then there's another one afterwards. And, you know, and it's all experience and enjoying. And I think with this positive attitude, it's also a little part that is about the central nervous system, that you can actually stimulate electric stimuli into the muscles that makes you go further. So things like when people clap during a marathon, it's like, oh, if you listen to music or something, it can actually stimulate the body to go faster. And I believe that you can also do it yourself. You can, like, if you think positive, you can actually stimulate your own body. And when you hear people running, they go, oh, I can't. Of course they can, because they're sending the signal and the body sends it to the muscles, and so they can't, you can't. And I think it's sort of like, this positive attitude that you can have when you have a strong and healthy body, you know, and wonderful people around. And yeah, I would really like to also talk about this, you know, because I'm training a few people, and what I always say, it doesn't matter if you run or if you walk, but what is really makes a difference in the training, for example, if you want to become better, is that you do different speeds, you know, because that permits to the heart to recover. And it's in the recovery that you get faster, because the heart starts to recover faster. And I would really like, if we have time in the workshop, you know, to do some of these techniques of, it's called fartlek, really, which makes that you run fast and slow and fast and slow.
Yeah.
And which makes, even if you do it walking, it makes a difference, you know. And this is one of the really simple techniques for making people recover, so they can, even if they run the same speed as always, that they can enjoy more. And that's, I think that's also one of the ideas behind the training. It's not only to become faster, it's also to suffer less and become and enjoy more, you know. I'm going to do a run now, we're going to do it as a team. And of course, I can only go as fast as the other team person, but I can suffer less. And so if I suffer less than him, then I can motivate him, or he can motivate me. And who knows who is going to be the strongest one on that day.
Sure.
So you can push and help each other. And so it's, I think training about this, it's about enjoying.
Yeah, fantastic.
And of course, with this diet, it's, get so much energy, you just have to spend it in a way. And
what I think is really interesting, though, from speaking to you in the past, Harriet, is that although you do these really long runs and you do a lot of training, you don't actually eat like a huge amount more than the average person would. I don't think.
I don't eat a lot. I don't know. People say it's about metabolism, but there's a percentage of it that is metabolism, but there's also a part that isn't, you know. And I think, I don't know how much is the percentage that is actually influenced by the metabolism, but it's not a lot. I mean, it will be maybe 200 or 300 calories of difference between a high metabolism and a low metabolism. So it's not really this or this. I think it's about efficiency, maybe. And maybe we don't need to eat that much. I mean, I don't know. I'm not such a good example.
What is your kind of daily, how much would you
eat? Daily, it's about, even if I train really hard, I will go around 2,000.
Right.
And I have this sort of, yeah, if I eat more, then I become fat. it's really simple, you know. I can't eat. I'm one of the persons that I can't eat more because my body just hold on to it, you know.
Wow, really?
Mm-mm. And yeah, if it's genetic stuff, I mean, I'm not going to show you my family, but so it's quite practical actually for the ultra runs. Or maybe I do the ultra runs because I don't need a lot of food, and so I can really hang on for a long time, and I think that battery. I have to find a charger. Sorry.
Oh, it's okay. We can.
And I think that. Yeah. Can we just have a break?
Yeah, we'll cut it.
Yeah. Okay, saved by the electricity.
Okay.
That fortunately, most of it in Denmark is made by solar and wind power, so it's okay. You can use it.
Okay, let's get back into it.
Yeah. So about the quantity of food that I eat, yeah, I don't feel I need to eat so much as many of the people I run with. I mean, because I think that I'm very well nourished all the time.
Hold it.
Oh? It's not like many people, they eat only really good for the last week before a race, you know, but
right.
If you eat very good for the last year or the last 10 years or all life, then you're all the time well, it's really difficult, well nourished.
Yeah,
and so I think that the body just knows what to take and how to take it, and yeah, and it's very practical because you don't need to eat all the time and feel heavy while you eat. I mean, I can also think it's also about this sort of endurance thing and the limits of the body, maybe. Because it's okay if I don't eat today, I will eat tomorrow, you know. If it's exceptional during a race or something like this, and if I don't sleep this week, I will sleep next week. It's about accepting whatever condition you're in and say, I know what is my base, and my body know that I treat it really well. So if I do exceptionally some really hard things, then it's okay because it knows, and I know that I will give it all the. And I'm not talking about, you know, damaging things, but sport is yeah, of course it's very hard to the body, but it also gives you so much pleasure that I think it's not that bad.
Yeah.
I mean, some people have been talking to me about being addicted to sport and to running and this sort of thing, and I think it's a choice, really. I don't feel it's and it's really a great one. And when you go like I do, I feel a little bit like an adventurer. And now I'm back in my childhood town in Denmark, and we went running in the forest where I used to run around when I was a child, and it's more or less the same thing, you know. We just do the same thing. When you're a child, it's okay to go out in the morning with a backpack and some bananas and apples, and you just stay in the forest and you run around all day. But when you become an adult, it becomes endurance sport, and it's really dangerous, you know. And when you're a child, it's not endurance sport. I mean, even if you're out in the forest running all day.
Sure.
So I think it's more about the same thing, and I feel quite. Like when I was a child, doing the same things, we just run around and play around, you know. Or we go to party. When my friends, they go for a party, they go into town, and I have another friend that we are runners, And when we go to party, we meet in the center of town at 11 on Saturday evening, and then we run for 80 kilometers, and this is our party, you know. Up on top of the mountain when the sun comes up, and then it's celebration, you know. And this is just about celebrating life in a different way, but yeah.
Sounds brilliant.
Oh, it is, really.
Yeah, I mean, I've been in the raw vegan movement for a number of years, and a lot of the things, I suppose a lot of the people that inspired me at first was all the athletes that were seemed to be having these amazing performances from it. And you brought up something earlier about recovery.
Yeah.
Which is funny, because I've not really been focusing on that so much over the last few years, but that was one of the big things when the 80-10-10 diet started to become popular. It was, as you were saying, it was really helping people with their athletic performance.
Yeah.
Recovery, is that really the big thing, that you're just recovering so quickly from your races? I mean,
it is. I mean, I've been doing like stage runs where we run for 5 days, but when we go to sleep in the evening, I mean, and people just crawl around across the floor, and we all sleep in like a gymnasium. For example, I'm doing one every year that we run across Costa Rica from the Pacific to the Caribbean, and we sleep along the way in like schools and things like this. It's a wonderful race called the Transtica, and it's also like a humanitarian race where we give material to the schools where we sleep in, and it's the parents in the school that make food for the people. They cook for the people, not for me, because of course I just pick whatever I need to. And that's why I got into running this race, because it's one of the only ultra races like on stages that you can actually do, because there's just so much food everywhere. I wouldn't be able to do this on the North Pole, you know. I can't, and I don't think I would go that far than to eat whatever they eat on the North Pole, just to run. Then I would really adapt. I did do one though in Greenland, and they said that I was the most expensive runner that I ever had there, because of course cucumbers in Greenland, it's really like, it's more expensive than whatever they were eating, reindeer burgers or but you know, so, but it was only a marathon, so it was okay, you know, but yeah, but in this run in Costa Rica, I could really see it clearly. You have 50 runners, and there's one that is just walking normally, and it's a fruitarian, you know. And all the others are really like, they're destroyed.
Oh, wow.
No, actually, we were there in the second year. I met a girl there that she also became a fruitarian, and she was also okay, you know.
Oh, wow.
And all the others just, you know.
That's amazing.
And, yeah, and we did became number one and two. First and second female in the race. So you can actually also get faster and stronger. And I've seen incredible improvements, you know. I've been doing the same races. I'm like sort of, I like to do this, how do you say, what I said before, the same things every day and the same races every year, and having these rituals. And I like to go back to do the same races and see the incredible improvement that you get over the years, you know. It's really fun. The last month I did a training race, an 80 kilometer training race, and I went from being number 65 of a general classification to number 29 in 1 year, you know. And it's really fast.
Okay.
I went down by 1 hour and 10 minutes.
Oh, wow.
And just, you know, and I mainly did just went to have fun, but then there's a moment when you see people just start to wobble, and you're just like, oh, are you okay, you know? And you feel that it's also because they take it really seriously and they go really for the race, and so they forget to enjoy. And I think you can't do these things only with muscle and diet. You have to do it also with your mind, and the mind, I mean, it's amazing what you can do with the mind, you know?
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, looking forward to having you at the Fruit Festival, yeah. And
I'm looking forward to it also. I mean, actually, I just have to say one thing. I was a fruitarian for a raw vegan for 3 years before going to a festival, and I didn't actually meet anybody before that, and I felt such a difference from when I went to the first festival in Denmark. like how it feels to be in this community, you know, of having been for 3 years like on my own with YouTube or whatever. But when you go to the festivals, you just feel a part of a community. And when you're, especially in the winter when there's less festivals, you're not alone, you know, you have the all the people, they're all here. They're all on my back. Feel a part of a community, and it's such a great feeling, you know.
Amazing. No, that's brilliant. So how do people, if people want to hear more about you, can, where do they follow you? On Instagram?
Yeah.
Is it, or?
Yeah, I have Instagram and I have Facebook also. It's okay. Harriet Kjaer. It's written Kjaer.
Okay.
And well, if anybody come to Barcelona to visit, please feel free to come. I have a really nice rooftop garden in the middle of Barcelona, and you know, so there's room to put up a tent in on the terrace.
Oh wow! Brilliant.
So anybody is welcome. You know,
fantastic.
Got some wonderful fruits, and not a lot of organic, unfortunately, uh-huh. in Barcelona. So it's a choice, you know, if you want to eat one small green organic mango, if you want to eat five incredible pure non-organic, I think,
sure.
you know, and if you want to eat to this, all these things, it's about choices, you know. If you can't have it all, then you have to compromise, and I think, yeah, unfortunately in Spain they're a little bit non-organic, but you know, but it's great food, great food.
Brilliant.
Yeah. Well, yeah, so yeah, on Instagram, on Facebook.
Fantastic.
And at the Fruit Festival.
Absolutely. So the Fruit Festival, Harriet's going to be part of it, and it's from August the 2nd to the 6th. You can find it more information at fruitfest.co.uk. There'll be a link down below this video. Please feel free to leave any questions or comments below the video, and share this with anyone that you think would like it, and subscribe for more videos related to this diet and lifestyle and everything else. And thanks for watching. Any final comments, Harriet, before we leave? Any words of inspiration for anyone out there who's thinking about changing to this kind of lifestyle?
Well, anybody feel free, if they have any questions, feel free to contact me, and I'm really happy to help. And I'm just looking forward to see you all. Go to health, as says Dr. Graham.
Fantastic. Thanks a lot, Harriet. See you soon.
See you then. Bye.